Good morning, dear students. Yes, how are you? Yes, I am also fine, and I hope all of you are fine. In the previous class, we have discussed about the medieval India. Yes, that is the which dynasty that ruled in the medieval India. Yes. So in this class, we are going to discuss about the next point. That is the next chapter. Third chapter, that is religious promoters and social reformers. Yes. So as we know, the period between 8th century and 13th century, it is very important in the socio-cultural history of India. And during the same period, Shankaracharya, Madhvacharya, Ramanujacharya, who are the founders of three Vedic religions, were living in India. Yes. And Dvaita, Advaita, Vishishtadvaita, these are the three major philosophies also came into existence. And Basveshwara of Kalyana, he declared social revolution against caste and gender based discrimination in order to achieve this ideal situation. And the three Acharyas and Basveshwara preached all the people to surrender to the God irrespective of caste, creed and richness. And they reviewed the society through Bhakti Marga. So let us discuss about the first person, Shankaracharya. Yes, so Shankaracharya, he was born in the village Kaladi, that is in Kerala. Yes, and he belongs to Nambudiri Brahmin family, and his father name is Shivguru, and his mother name is Aryamba. Yes, and Shankara was very intelligent. At the age of 7, he had mastered all the scriptures, and he learned Vedas and Puranas from his teacher. And his teacher name is Govinda Bhagavatpad. Yes, and Shankaracharya studied the Upanishads, Brahma Sutras in depth, and propagated the Advaita philosophy. According to this, Brahma is the absolute truth, the rest of the world is false. Yes. So Shankaracharya, he propagated the Advaita philosophy. Yes, which philosophy? That is Advaita philosophy. And according to this philosophy, Brahma is the absolute truth. Yes, Brahma, it is absolute truth, and rest of the world is false. So this philosophy is given by Shankaracharya, so that we called Advaita philosophy. And the soul is one with Brahma, and life is not separate from Brahma. Yes, so our soul is one with Brahma, and life is not separate from Brahma. Yes, so the world is Maya and illusion. Yes, so world, it is Maya. Yes, and Brahma is the absolute truth. Yes, but Brahma is only absolute truth, and people are ignorant, they are not aware of the illusionary nature of the world. Yes, and they are also not aware that Brahma is the only truth. Hence, we should go on the path of knowledge and realize the nature of the world, and ultimately we should merge our Atma with the absolute truth, that is Brahma. Yes, and only then we can attain moksha, that is liberation. Yes, and in this manner Shankaracharya taught the path of knowledge. Yes, so the human soul has no separate existence, and he expressed that aham brahmasmi. Yes, and he declared that Brahma, it is only one truth, and it has no qualities, no futures and no shape. Yes, that is nirguna, nirakara and nirvikara. Yes, so let us discuss about the next some important works of Shankaracharya. So Shankara Bhashya, Ananda Lahari, Saundarya Lahari, Shivananda Lahari, Viveka Chudamani, Prabuddha, Sudhakara and Dakshina Murti Stotra. So these are some important works that was created by Shankaracharya. And his hymen, Pashuku Vindam. It is very world famous, and Shankaracharya, he traveled from Kanyakumari to Kashmir on foot and propagated his Advaita philosophy in order to spread the message of his philosophy. And also he established the pithas, that is institutions, in all four directions. That is, Shankaracharya gave Indian thinking a new direction and inspiration. So he has established some pithas on the four direction. For example, Badri, that is Jyotri Pitha, Dwarka, Kalika Pitha, Puri, Govardhan Pitha, next Sringeri, Sharda Pitha, Kanchi, that is Kamakoti Pitha. So these are some important pithas that was established by Shankaracharya. Next prominent person is Ramanujacharya. So Ramanujacharya was born in C. Perambandur, that is near Chennai, and Keshava Somayaji was his father and Kantimati was his mother. Yes, so Shankaracharya Ramanujacharya, he was born in C. Perambandur, that is near Chennai. His father name is Keshava Somayaji, mother name is Kantimati. Got it? And he read Veda and Upanishads, Yadav Prakash in Kanchi. Yes, and the famous learning center, that is in South India. Yes, so then he went to Srirangam and became head of Mata, and the Chola ruler who was Shaivite started pestering Ramanujacharya, and he was invited to Bittideva, the Hoysala king of Karnataka, and it is said that later Bittideva accepted Vaishnava tradition and he became Vishnuvardhana. Yes, and Ramanuja, he went to Melukote and built Cheluva Narayana temple. Yes, so Cheluva Narayana temple, it was created by Ramanujacharya. And Ramanujacharya had keen interest to show the path of salvation to the common people, and his philosophy is called as Vishishtadvaita. Yes, his philosophy is called as Vishishtadvaita, whereas Shankaracharya's philosophy is known as Advaita. Fine. And according to his philosophy, Jiva, that is life or Prakriti or nature, are under the control of Brahma. Yes, that is life and nature, it is controlled under the Brahma, and both Atma and Paramatma cannot become one simultaneously. Yes, and he said that world is expressed manifestation of Brahma and world is a reality. Yes, and in order to achieve Mukti, that is salvation, Bhakti and Prapati, that is complete surrenders to God, are very important. Yes, if you want to Mukti or salvation, we have to adopt Bhakti and Prapati. Yes, and Ramanujacharya criticized caste system and he preached his teaching to all. Yes, he has also criticized the caste system during that days, and he taught them to stay away from desires and surrender themselves to the will of God with complete devotion, and like this he advocated bhakti path for moksha. And Ramanujacharya, he studied many religious texts and he also wrote many books like Vedanta Sangra. Yes, here you can see the some important books that are written by Ramanujacharya. First one is Vedanta Sangraha, Vedanta Sara, Vedanta Deepika, Sri Bhashya. Yes, so these are the some important books that were written by Ramanujacharya. And he has also given importance and prominence to Bhakti path in his important books, that is Gita Bhashya. And Saint Ramananda and Rai Dasa of North India were greatly influenced by Ramanujacharya philosophy. And similarly, the Aravidu and Tuluva dynasty of Vijayanagara kingdom were the followers of this philosophy. Yes, and he has also established some mutts, that is in South India. For example, Yathiraja Matha, that is in Melukote, and Parakala Matha, that is in Mysore, Ahobala Matha, that is in Ahobala, that is in Guntur, Andhra Pradesh. Next, Anandavana Matha, that is in Srirangam. Next, Vami Malai Matha, that is in Suchindram. So these are the some important mathas that was established by Ramanujacharya. So thank you for watching this video, and I hope you have understood this. And in the next class, we will discuss about the remaining personality. Okay, thank you.